Vitiligo is a rare skin disorder characterized by the destruction of melanocytes, resulting in loss of skin color and the appearance of whitish patches on the skin. It affects around 1% of the global population. Regardless of gender or ethnicity, it predominantly impacts individuals between the ages of 20 and 30. In this inspiring account, Vivian Najuka takes center stage as an unwavering defender of vitiligo victims' rights. Vivian Najuka, an esteemed assistant lecturer at Kabale University and the Reverend Chairperson of the Vitiligo Association of Uganda, explains how she experienced the onset of vitiligo during her final year of studying library and information science at Makerere University in 2004.
From nowhere, I just started seeing some small patches. They started with my mouth and gradually they increased, and then they went to the face on my left hand side of the face. They also started like a small spot, and then it went on gradually spreading in a very short time. In fact, they took like a 4 month to spread almost a half of my face.
Najuka narrates how she got into a period of profound depression as she grappled with the enigmatic changes occurring within her body. Besieged by myths and misconceptions from those around her, Najuka chose self-isolation as a defense against public ridicule.
A lot of things that happened to me, that to some extent that I would be indoors fearing to go move out before the public. And it took me some time to cope with it, because in the first place I didn't know how it was called. People around me too, they didn't know how it was called until I went to the internet and discovered that it was called vitiligo.
Najuka's unyielding faith and acceptance of Jesus Christ gave her strength to embrace this condition and live life with an unwavering positive outlook.
It's my fellow students, but some of the fellow students, some extent, those who are my friends, somehow started distancing themselves from me. But I thank God, after going through all that, I opted for salvation, and that's when I started accepting myself. Because before salvation, I'd wanted to commit suicide. The stress was too much that I would move in Kampala, in the city, and these barriers could always mock me.
Najuka embarked on an arduous journey of self-education and research, determined to understand and cope with vitiligo. Her commitment to acquiring knowledge empowered her to develop effective strategies to manage the challenges posed by the skin disorder.
Internet helped me so much, because I can say that even some of the medical dermatologists did not also know exactly how it was called. So it was not until then I searched a lot on the internet. I happened to have gone to Nigeria to represent our country on the same. We shared a lot with other countries, and we came to learn a lot of things. Then I came with some literature, books, leaflets, which I started spreading some of the dermatologists, doctors I could come across.
In 2019, Najuka joined forces with other individuals affected by vitiligo to establish the Vitiligo Association of Uganda, a dynamic organization dedicated to advocating for the rights and well-being of people living with vitiligo.
After realizing that there are many people out there who are living with a condition, they are not advocated, they are going through a lot of stress and stigma, isolation, and they really need some kind of association where they can go and also share their differences, interact with similar others. So that's how the Vitiligo Association of Uganda came into existence.
She appeals to government to provide support by recognizing the distinctive needs for individuals living with vitiligo and ensuring their access to adequate care.
People living with vitiligo in Uganda, we are very many. We need the support from the government, and since I saw that has a heart for us, a sympathetic heart for us, we need his support so much, and the entire government, Minister of Health, and any other stakeholders who may really feel sympathetic to us, because vitiligo does not have boundaries to anybody to whom it is going to affect. It can affect anybody, irrespective of their age, social income, gender, color, because it's also so common in the whites. It has no boundaries. It can attack anybody at any age.
Najuka underscores the pivotal role of her husband's unwavering support played in their union. She calls upon society to view vitiligo victims as ordinary human beings deserving of love, empathy, and equal opportunities.
I have a vote of thanks to my husband who has loved me the way I am, and appealing to many men out there and women who may identify as a spouse who is suffering from or living with vitiligo. Don't refuse to approach this person because he has vitiligo. If you're a man and you have seen a lady, it's good. You're a woman, you have seen a man, he has vitiligo. That's just something on top.
When I approached her, I asked, that was the first question, I asked, what happened to you? And she told me how situation started years back when she was at the university. And then that one could not scare me. Instead, I felt that I should give her a company. I should love her. I should stand with her in all conditions.
This is Vivian Najuka's story as the world observes World Vitiligo Day under the theme Vitiligo, Looking into the Future, sets the change for continued progress towards awareness and acceptance. Report compiled by Job Namanya for the news.